So ninth class, today we are to continue with the writer topics, okay? And today our lecture is how to save document in writer, right? Now save, already you are very much familiar with this concept. By save we mean we keep the copy of our file for permanent storage into our computer, okay? And the file is permanently stored in the disk till we delete the file. Right? So how to store the or save the file in writer? There are three methods. As per the first method, you click on the file menu and choose the save option, okay? Or you can press Control plus S shortcut key from the keyboard. Or third method is you can click on save icon on standard toolbar, right? I just show the open office to you people. Open office. Writer. When you save the file in Writer, the extension of the file is ODT. The extension of the file is ODT, okay? I just minimize this. Yeah. Is the writer window visible now? Yes, class. Is the writer window visible? Students, hurry up. Give the response fast. All right. Now see this window. Here I'll be telling you all the possible methods to save the file. First of all, click on the file menu, choose the save option. Okay, first method. Second, press Control plus S shortcut key from the keyboard, right? And third method is click on the save icon on standard toolbar, right? Whichever method you are opting, the save as dialog box will appear. In the file name box, by default, untitled one name is appearing. I told you yesterday, by default, the name of the file in OpenOffice Writer is untitled one, right? Now you can specify any suitable name to your file, like I am giving here. Chapter Writer. I have given the name Chapter Writer. Okay. So the extension that the file will take is ODT. .ODT is the extension of the file saved in OpenOffice Writer. Okay. All the methods are totally clear to all of you. Any doubt, any queries? All right. Is the PPT visible now? So I'm closing this PPT and I'll be opening the second PPT in front of you. Is the PPT visible? So let us continue with the topics. Next topic is how to close the document. Beta, there is one concept to close the document. Second concept is exit from the writer. Closing the document does not mean that you are quitting from the writer application window. But exit from writer application window means you are quitting the application window. Okay? There are two different concepts. To close the document does not mean that you are quitting or you are exiting from writer window. But if I say exit from the writer application window, it means you are completely coming out of the software. Okay. So the document in which you are currently working, that becomes your current document. How to close the document? There are four possible ways in 4.1.9 version. First method, click on the file menu and choose the close option. In the diagram, you can see, I have taken the screenshot of it for your convenience. Click on file menu and choose the close option. This is the first method. Second method is click on close document button present on the right corner of menu bar. This is your menu bar and see the top right corner here in the screenshot. You can see this cross icon. This cross icon is known as close document icon. When you will click on it, the current document will get closed. Then, third method is you click on the window menu and choose close window option. In the window menu, you choose the close window option. And the fourth method is press Control plus W shortcut key from the keyboard. All the four methods, if clear, raise your thumb to give the feedback. Immediately raise your thumb to give the feedback to me. Ishani and Anshya, be alert whose thumb is up and whose thumb is not. Laksh Taneja, are you attending the class? Laksh Taneja, your audio is off. All right. So as I told you that closing the document does not mean that you are closing the application window. I just show it practically to you people. Beta, is the writer window visible? Is the Writen application software visible to all? All right. Now see what I'm going to do. Suppose I type some document here. I increase the font size. I am teaching computer application subject to 9C class. Today is Tuesday, 13th July, and third period is going on. Okay. Third period is going on. Now see, if I click on the file menu and I choose the close option, it is asking me to save the changes. Let me save the changes. I am saving the changes in document writer one. Okay. See this. The current document get closes. If you want to again open, click here. Right. Now, if I choose window, close window option, again the same process. If I press Control plus W, again the same process. Now see this close document icon at the top right corner of the menu bar. I click here, again the same option. Now this is close the current document. Okay. Since I am working only in one document, अभी मैंने सिर्फ एक document बनाया है, तो वो मेरा current document है. Okay. Now the concept is how to exit from the writer. If I click on the file menu and I choose the exit option, I will come out of the writer application window. I will come out of the writer application window. Or if I press control plus Q shortcut key, control plus Q shortcut key. Or third method to exit from the writer is by clicking on this cross button at the top right corner of title bar. Title bar ke upar jo cross icon hai, when you will click on that, you will come out of the writer application window. Now see what I'm going to do. I click on the file menu. I click on exit option. See, writer window get closes. Writer application window get closes. Have you observed it, all of you? Yes, students, is the concept clear? And the difference between closing document and exiting writer application window? Very less thumbs are raised. Navedita, Dhairya, Ishani, Gurupal, no feedback coming from you people. Is the concept clear? Gurleen, Ritika, Gurshan, Simran, is the concept clear? All right. Kanish and Harshit, if any window is not visible, please let me know immediately. Okay. So exit is also done. Now the concept is margins. When you are writing question answers in your notebook, many a times you have seen margins are drawn in on the pages of notebook. And you write the first letter, first word from the margin. Okay. Now what actually is a margin? The distance between the text and the paper edge. Paper edge means kagaz ka kinara, paper ka kinara. Okay. The difference between the text that you have typed and the paper edge means paper ka kinara. That gap is called margin. When you receive your answer sheet while appearing for the examination, many students, they pick up the scale and they draw margins. They leave some portion from the beginning. They draw the margin, and the portion they have left in the beginning, that is margin. Okay. So how many types of margins are there? Left margin, right margin, top margin, and bottom margin. What is left margin? I show you by opening the writer application window. Is the writer window visible, Kanish and Harshit? You can see this line, these lines, the square shaped line which is already visible on the page, this box, this is margin. And the ruler at the top, this horizontal ruler, is used to set the left margin and the right margin. It is used to set this left margin and right margin. This vertical ruler here, it is used to set the top margin and the bottom margin. Okay? Clear? Still, if you don't want to use the ruler and you want to make settings for the margins without using the ruler, one option is there. You have ruler available with you and you can make changes with respect to the margins. You can make settings with respect to the margins. But without using the ruler, if you want to make settings for your margins, the method is click on the format menu, go to page option, page style dialog box will appear. Click on the page tab and see this margin section. Can you see the margin section here where my mouse pointer is moving? And you can make changes for margin value. You can increase or decrease the margins as per your convenience. Okay, and click on the OK button. Accordingly, the margins will get set up. Clear? So what is left margin? Left margin means the distance between the text and the left edge of the paper. This is left edge where my mouse is moving. This is left edge. The distance between the text and the left edge is left margin. The distance between the text and the right edge of the paper is right margin. The distance between the text and the top edge of the paper is top margin. And distance between the text and the bottom edge of the paper is bottom margin. Okay? Am I clear? Is the concept of margin clear to all of you? Okay, now is indentation. What is indentation? Indentation means how much, at how distance your text appears from the margin. I show it practical to you people. I type here something. Let me increase the size. I am teaching class 9th C. There are 44 computer students in the class. Today is 13th July and third period is going on. Okay, this is the text I have typed and I make it justify alignment. Okay. Now, from where I have started my text, see here, I am teaching. I started typing from the left margin. Okay. Now, what is indentation? See carefully what I'm going to do. I selected the text. There is one button here with the arrow inside, and this button is called increase indent. Have you noticed the button? Yes, class, is the button visible? Increase indent button. You can see a yellow tooltip is coming to give the name of the button. Click on this. See, as I click on this, the text is going inward. See again, I click on increase indent. The text has gone little inward from the left margin. Pehle wo left margin ke bilkul pass tha. Ab wo andar ki aur shift ho raha hai. Are you noticing the change? Harshit, Barbie, Navedita, Ishani, Gurupal. Is the change visible to all? This is positive indent. This is positive indent. So what is generally, what is indentation? Indentation is the gap or the distance between the text and the margin. This gap is indentation. Okay? Am I clear to all? Let me tell you more clearly. Drawing toolbar. You can see this gap. Ye arrow dekh rahe ho? This arrow signifies the distance. Ye indentation hai. This is indentation. And right now, the indentation which is visible in front of you is called positive indent. In positive indent, text is little inward from the left margin. Now see, I again select the text. Okay. And I decrease indent. See. Now text is coming out from the margin. Text has come out of the margin. See here. Text margin ko bhi cross kar gaya. The text is coming outward from the margin. This is called negative indent. This is called negative indent. Okay? Am I clear? The third one is first line indent. The third one is first line indent. Agar aapki first line andar ki aur ho jaye. See here, these two lines are indented with respect to the first line. This is first line indent. Okay. I think all the three type of indents are clear to all. Right? So let me show the PPT again. So what is indentation? Indentation is the distance between the text boundary and the page margins. Okay. And the three type of indentation. First is positive indent. So what is positive indent? Positive indent means the text is narrower. Text is narrower than space between the margins, that is text is little inward from the margin. Negative indent means the text flows out from the margin. And what is hanging indent? Hanging indent means first line is normal, the other lines, they are indented from the first line. Like I show you here, this first line is as such, the next two lines, they are further indented. Inko maine aur andar ki aur kar diya. This is hanging indent. This is hanging indent. Okay? Clear? So this is the diagrammatic view of indentation. You can see this diagram. It will clearly explain you the meaning of all type of indentations: positive, negative, and hanging. See the positive indent, text is inward from the margin. In negative indent, text is outward from the margin. And in the hanging indent, first line is okay, normal. The next lines, they are further indented, right? Now, next concept is line spacing. What is line spacing? By name, it is very much clear. The total height of the line. How much space you are giving in between the lines. Normally in the notebook, when you finish one line, you come down to the next line. If you leave one line in between blank, कई बच्चे एक लाइन छोड़ के लिखते हैं. If you leave one complete line, blank line in between, okay, then try to imagine the gap between two lines. आपने फर्स्ट लाइन लिखी, आपने एक लाइन ब्लैंक छोड़ दी, फिर थर्ड लाइन में लिखा, फिर फोर्थ लाइन ब्लैंक छोड़ दी, लाइक दिस. सो दिस टोटल हाइट ऑफ लाइन इंक्लूडिंग द स्पेसिंग दैट यू आर गिविंग is called line spacing. Basically, there are three type of line spacing. Line spacing 1, line spacing 1.5, and double line spacing. I just show the writer view to you. Okay, I select the lines, right? And this is the line spacing 1.5 icon. This is line spacing 2. See these two buttons, line spacing 1.5. See, 1.5 gap between each lines. The gap between one line and the second line is 1.5. Okay. Now see, I'm giving line spacing 2. Have you noticed the gap between the lines? Yes, class. Have you observed the gap? This is double line spacing. Earlier I gave 1.5 line spacing. Okay. And the third one is the normal line spacing, that is 1. No spacing, just 1. The default spacing, normal spacing. Okay. Am I clear with the concept of line spacing to all of you? So there are three type of line spacing, single 1.5 and double. Single line spacing is equivalent to 12 points. 1.5 line spacing is equivalent to 18 points. And double line spacing is equivalent to 24 points, right? So how you can set the line spacing? Select the text, click on line spacing 1, line spacing 1.5, or line spacing 2 button.